Hello guys, this is the sixth video from the course 3D camera animation and rigging techniques. In this tutorial, we will learn how to create preview animations in 3ds Max. So, the first question is, why should we create preview animations? When we animate the camera in a project, then we create preview animations for all of these camera animations. Firstly, because they are quick and normally takes few minutes instead of hours like in rendering. Secondly, at this time we are finalizing our camera. When the director sees all the camera animations in a sequence, the director can change the camera movement if he doesn't like it. This will definitely save time, and you know, time is money in 3D. So without any further ado, let's get started. The first thing that I will do is that I will go to the camera that I want to make the preview. Next, I will click here, left click, and I will select my camera to know the frames that have been used in the animation. Right now, 250 frames are used in this camera animation. After checking the frames, I go to Tool, Preview, Grab Preview, and click on Create Animation Previews. Now, if the animation is on the whole timeline, then I will click Active Time Segment. Else, I will choose a custom range. Click here and enter your starting 0 and your ending frames here. Next, make sure only geometry and background is checked and others are off. Normally, I don't want splines and helpers to be on in my preview. Keep the percent of output to 100. Per view preset from high quality to standard. I always keep it to standard. Preferences to default shading. After this, click on the file and choose a path. Give it a name. Click here. The file should be AVI. And remember, after this, you have to choose your setup. This is extremely important. Do not miss it. By default, the compressor type is DV video encoder. If you keep this encoder, the preview will always be small. It will not be the size that you have defined in your render. So change it to JPEG compressor. Quality 75 is enough. You don't need to go more than this. Remember, one more thing here, that the maximum preview it can make is of 1 GB. So if you take it to 100 and you have a very long frame, it will not be able to make it complete. So keep it to 75, 70, 60 like this, and keep your compressor to this. And now click save. Lastly, select the camera from here that you want to render and click create. Once the rendering is done, it will play the video automatically, but if it doesn't, you can always play it manually. So this is how I create my preview animations, and they save a lot of time because after creating them, I put all of them into After Effects and I compile there, and I know that my timing and my camera angles are okay. If I need to change it, I change it, and then again I make a preview of it. So guys, I hope you like this series. If you like it, give it a like. If you love it, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating guys. Bye bye.